Well, that was a Shabbat song. Shabbat is coming soon, so I thought I'd open up with that. Improvisation, which is what I intend to do for you. For me, that's music. That's the music. It's more than my music. If I compose something, okay, it's my music. But if I feel something and I just let it come through me and I just play completely off the top of my head, what I feel this moment, the way it is, it's sort of like an instant composition. I mean, improvising in a way is composing right now. It's kind of streaming composing. For me, that's the music, and probably what makes music interesting for me. And I think if it wasn't for improvisation, I'd probably quit a long time ago. And that way, I took something from Indian music. You know, in Indian music, you sort of have night ragas, day ragas. It's actually different flavors and scales that they associate them with the feeling of night, early morning, dawn. And it's supposed to reflect a certain feeling. Actually, every scale does that. You can use this superlative or another. And this is kind of driven from an Indian tradition, where traditionally, in the Indian tradition, within a whole concert, the compositions take about 5% of the time, and the improvisations take 95% of the time, naturally. Thank you. traditional Shabbat song. It actually goes like that. Ki eshmera Shabbat elishmerni otehi leyol meyad benovni ki eshmera Shabbat elishmerni otehi leyol meyad. I think it's kind of time. The Shabbat is coming really soon now. They put me in a good angle so that I can actually see when the sun is coming down. And there is a moment during the week that I take a pause from life, actually, from everything. It's a magic moment. Because, you know, my agent is there and musicians I work with are all over the world. And in Tel Aviv, I have some stuff that I have to do, and I'm on the internet and in the Facebook and on the cell phone with somebody in the other side of the country. And suddenly this moment comes when the sun goes down on Friday, and it's like somebody took a needle and went, pow, and it's all gone. And the only thing that's left is what is here and now. At the actual present, not only in time, but the present also geographically, here. Because we don't live here anymore. Our minds are so diffused all over the place. And we have so much business to take care of. And it seems like every invention that mankind managed to invent, in a way, gave him more work. They invented the mail so that you don't have to run and give the message. And then they invented the internet so that you don't even have to go there and give the mail. But now you have to take care of your MySpace, whatever, Picasa, this, that, website, here, there, and answer 150 emails a day. And in the past, if somebody gave you a message, let's say somebody called 15 years ago, then the day after, you would try again if you didn't answer. And today, if you don't answer the SMS within an hour and a half, you already have three question marks, like, what's going on, dude? We're waiting here. And if they're looking for a guitar player and they call you and you're not answering today, tomorrow they already have one. They go down the list, the one after you. And life has went on a pace, on a rhythm, that is, in a way, an unnatural rhythm for me. And so it's like a sanctuary. It's a moment of sanity inside my whole week. Normally, I run around playing a lot and working 10, 12 hours a day, and then suddenly this moment comes and it's absolutely paf. Wow.
So you stop doing anything and
absolutely.
How do you feel of stopping doing what you are? What is most important in your life? Playing, composing.
I don't stop the music. Music is you make music here and here, and with your hands and legs you execute the music that you've already made, hopefully, and that's, or at least that's the good way to make music. And when you stop working with your hands, you have a moment to observe what you want. You have a moment where you're not busy with your... You have two sets of ears. One set of ears is on your head and you hear the stuff that happens outside. And the other set of ears is inside, your spiritual set of ears. Okay? And like you can see in the eyes of your spirit, you can also hear in the ears of your spirit. And that's a good moment to listen to the music you really have inside. It's a kind of a moment of refinement where you look at everything you've done and you look at everything you want to do and you reconsider. And that's a good thing. In a way, it also gives you a moment that you can be silent. Come join me.
So you wouldn't play anymore?
Today?
Yes.
Right now?
Yes.
No. Actually, they're gonna have to take it back to the hotel for me, because once it's Shabbat, I'm not gonna touch it anymore.
And don't write music. Don't compose.
No, you can't write. You can't. No physical attachments. You know, no strings to reality. You live in an inner world in a way. I compose my best work. I compose during Shabbat, and the toughest work is actually to remember it by the end of it. Because sometimes you have something amazing, and it's too complicated. And usually, if it's really yours, it comes back. You know, so. And
I think reflecting what is writing down on the first chapter of Genesis, God was creating Earth. 6 days, and on 7 days, what was going on?
You might ask, why does God need a rest?
Yes,
He's Almighty,
what
right?
For? We have to work.
He worked real hard, and now He needs a break. Okay, does that make sense? You're laughing, because it doesn't. In a way, I think the Book of Genesis is not the historical story about how and when the world was made. I think it's a story about what the world was made for, or maybe even better yet, what we were made inside the world for. It's a sort of plan for man, eventually. And the highlight of this week, on the sixth day, just about this time, man is made. And the moment after that, there is a day where it says, Vayanach b'yom ha-shavi'i, you will rest on the seventh day. And that's important. That's an important lesson for us, or maybe an instruction, or maybe we don't always see it an instruction. You know, it's questionable if it's the Ten Commandments or the Ten Suggestions, you know, according to the way people behave. But let's say that it's some sort of a blue code, a print that we work according to. It's a system where. It creates balance between doing and not doing. Not doing is important. It's important for your doing. It's like we learn the value of light from the darkness. If you never experience darkness, light is absolutely meaningless. If you never experience silence, sound is absolutely meaningless. And you need this opposite. And for me, the moment that I lay everything aside, to be honest, it's where the music starts, or it's where it's, better yet, it's where
it starts.
It's where it is born, okay? Maybe, you know, so everything is born in idea before it materializes. This table, this chair, and this buzuki, somebody thought about it before it happened. Nothing happens before you think about it. And while you're busy running around doing what you do in your everyday life, it's not necessarily for granted that you have the clarity to think well. So this moment of stand still, hold, pause, everything. There is no time that matters for the moment. There's nowhere I have to go. There's nobody I must speak with. And I'm, in a way, free. Free of what? Free of myself. And even the idea that it's given to you, it's dictated which day you're going to rest, is a great way to become free of yourself. Because by accepting rules, we earn freedom. Because the biggest thing we're slave to, the biggest thing we are tied to, with the heaviest chain we can never break, is our own perception, and our own idea, and our own awareness, and our own, the way we see life. We see everything through our eyes. And we have to think about everything we do. Should I do it? Is it right? Is it not? Why should I? Why not? You know? Okay, if you manage to let go of your own mind, of your own ideas, then for a moment, you may be free to look at them in another perspective, to evaluate them, to see them. And by actually accepting a rule is the only way you can earn freedom, because freedom with no rules is meaningless, like light without darkness, like sound without silence. So I accept it.
Chessboard, black, white.